Hey, Gopher fans, it's Mike Grimm from Gopher Radio and gophersports.com. It's another edition of Gopher Talk. It's presented by Affinity Plus. Affinity Plus, committed to the safety of their members, their employees, and communities during this time. You can learn more at affinityplus.org. And it's our pleasure to welcome one of the all-time great Golden Gopher softball players who is now returning to campus as a new assistant coach for new head coach Piper Ritter. Katie Richardson, good to see you.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. It's an exciting time. Good to be back.
Yeah, how excited are you about this situation coming back into a program that you helped build?
Oh, gosh, I cannot even put it into words. And even, you know, since I've been there, the strides that they have taken, I am just so excited to be a part of it and to help them grow and be a part of Coach Ritter's staff.
Yeah, and obviously Coach Ritter was part of the staff when you played. What kind of chemistry with this new staff can you foresee? Because I think it's a staff that everybody wants to be Gophers.
Yeah, I know. It's so fun. It's going to be so dynamic. I think, you know, when Coach Ritter first called me and talked to me about the job, it was just, it worked, right? I mean, she knows who I am. I know who she is. You know, she watched me grow up as a player. And then Coach Wynn on the other side of it. I mean, we got to coach together at ASU for a couple years, have a World Series team there. And so, I mean, I think the dynamic is going to be amazing. I think that all three of us complement each other really well, and I couldn't ask for a better staff to be a part of.
Well, we obviously watched you as a player and watched you compete and watched you help the Gophers take those next steps, and then ultimately that foundation helped lead them to Oklahoma State last year, which I'm sure you were following as well. But take me back to your time as a player and what things you learned there that you can implement now as a coach for this program.
Yeah, I mean, I think first and foremost, when I think of Gopher softball and I think of, you know, the program that my teammates and I kind of helped start and build and kind of use that as a platform from the previous players that were also there, I think that we learned how to do everything right. And not in the sense of we were perfect, but we knew that, you know, we had to do things well and be excellent on and off the field to succeed. And that's how we were able to be put in a successful situation and a position to, I think, catapult the program moving forward. So, you know, whether it came to going to class and getting good grades or running through the line with Coach Y in weightlifting, it was always something that we prided ourselves on, that we didn't take any shortcuts. And I think that is kind of been a key in my coaching philosophy and in life, really. There's no shortcuts to anywhere worth going, right? And I think that the Gophers really embodied that. And we took it to heart, and we took it to heart being, you know, the team from the North that wanted to compete, and we worked our butts off to do it. It didn't come easy, and we worked hard, and I think that goes a long way.
Yeah, and I think back to those teams, there was a toughness about those teams. There was not going to be any intimidation. You felt, it seemed to me, Coach Allister especially would instill in you guys, if you work hard, you have a chance to win, and it doesn't matter what the other team is about. If it's Michigan, if it's mm-hmm. Washington, whoever, you got to go out and know that you put the work into and you can win those games.
Yeah, I definitely think, you know, you can really draw confidence from knowing that you've put the work in. And I think we did that as a team. And like you said, I think we embodied it every single day. You know, we practiced when it was cold, or we practiced when it was raining, and we didn't care. We were going to get the job done, and however that looked. And I think, you know, it's funny. I think Coach Allister definitely instilled that, and Coach Ritter lived that. So having her now at the helm, it's so cool to me, because I think, you know, when I think of someone tough, I mean, Coach Ritter, she gets in there, she throws batting practice, you know, her arm's probably fallen off some days, but she didn't care, because she was going to do whatever it took to make us better as hitters and make us better as a team. And so, you know, overall, that whole staff, I think they brought a different and unique toughness to it. But I think really, we got to see Coach Ritter live that toughness. And then, I mean, she's just the pitchers that she's developed. It's just been, I mean, tough pitcher after tough pitcher in every sense of the way. So I definitely think there's going to be some of that, and just the competitiveness in those teams when I played. I mean, we wanted nothing more than to be the best Minnesota softball team that there ever was. And, you know, at that time, that was our goal. And guess what? I mean, obviously the next softball teams, they said, okay, we'll challenge you. We'll do it. We're going to go to the World Series now. But that's what I love. And that's what I'm excited for.
Now, a coaching staff that has a former pitcher who's going to call pitches as the head coach is a little different than maybe some others where a head coach who's going to be coaching third base and maybe using game strategies. Has Coach Piper Ritter talked to you at all about the roles of what everyone will be doing? And do you know kind of what at least preliminarily, what your duties will be as an assistant coach?
Yeah, I mean, we've got together a little bit as a staff. It's still pretty fresh, so there hasn't been, you know, too much talk about that. And, you know, it's funny because I actually come from a program at ASU where the head coach was a pitching coach as well. So it's an interesting dynamic because, like you said, there's not, you know, it's not as pervasive throughout college softball, but there is a ton, a group of people that have it. And I've actually already got to experience that. But, you know, I definitely think that I'll play a big piece in the hitting, you know, hitting strategy and things like that in the infield. And Coach Wynn will also do some hitting and outfield, which works. I think that, you know, we're going to be very dynamic in the sense of we're going to all work together on everything. I think that, you know, from Coach Ritter being heavy pitching, she can see things that hitters do from a pitcher's mindset. Just like, you know, Coach Wynn and I, we can do the same for pitchers from a hitter's mindset. So, not too much in the nitty gritty, but I think we all kind of have our little bit more niche areas. Right. And so, I'm excited to work with the hitters, and I think we're going to be very, you know, hitting and pitching this year. I think it's going to be, you're going to see a little bit. I think that's what Minnesota softball is kind of known to be as, usually. And I think that that's going to be definitely prevalent, big hitting, big pitching, and that's going to come back, but not too much in the nitty gritty of the details, but I'll definitely be doing hitting and infield.
And from that standpoint as well, recruiting obviously is always the lifeblood. And that was, I think, the key in terms of what Coach Allister was able to do. She went and got you and other players, and it wasn't just Minnesota. Although if there's good players in the state, you'll want to go get them, but there's places that you can make this a national situation. So how important is recruiting, and what kind of a skill set do you have that can help with that regard?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I think first and foremost, you have to have the right student athletes in place, right? So I'm a big culture person. Minnesota's a big culture university and athletic department in general. And so I think, you know, when we're recruiting, we're going to look for kids that really want to be a part of something that we're continuing to build and be a part of something bigger than themselves. But I definitely think recruiting is the lifeline, because at one point everyone's recruits, right? So I was a recruit at one point, you know, Tyler, Sarah, all the Sarahs that were a part of this program, right? Pfizer, everyone's been a recruit at one point. So I think, you know, like you said, recruiting is your lifeline. I think you have to go and you have to get the best kids in Minnesota. You know, you want the best talent to stay home, and you want the Den Hartogs, and you want them coming and playing for the University of Minnesota. You want it to be their dream school. I think it's really amazing that, you know, the University of Minnesota offers such a wide variety of, you know, between athletics and culture and, you know, being able to go downtown or do whatever. And I think that's unique. But I also think, you know, Coach Wynn being from Georgia and kind of the southeastern region, and then myself being in the southwestern region, and Coach Ritter has been recruiting, you know, everywhere, but she's got the Midwest down. So I definitely think that is going to be huge, that we kind of all have our different contacts and connections. And then as of, you know, for me, I think it's being able to not only spot talent, but be able to spot talent that you're going to be able to develop, and coachable kids that you think that will kind of fit your system as a program, and go out there. I mean, when a pitcher's striking kids out, you know, she's probably going to be pretty good, right? And then for hitters, it's just finding those unique athletes that look like they have what it takes to be successful at the next level. And, you know, you're never going to find someone that doesn't swing and miss, or someone that, you know, doesn't roll over a couple ground balls. But I think it's really having the eye for those that make adjustments. And even, you know, some of the things we're going to ask our student athletes now to do throughout the game, if they're already kind of having that hitter's mindset, that's something that we're going to be looking for. And just athletes, right? I mean, someone that we can throw it. You know, I never played third base until I came to college. So it's like, you got to be ready to go for whatever the team needs. So I think that'll be fun.
Am I looking right? You already have your nails done for Gopher Gold there. Is that
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I'm ready. I got maroon and gold. I mean, I've been waiting for this day for a long time.
Well, very good. We can't wait to get you on campus. I know that time's coming soon, and you're going to get right and rolling with Coach Ritter and the rest of the staff. And it's great to have you back.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. This has been so much fun. I look forward to being back at Jane Sage.
All right, very good. She's Katie Richardson, new Gopher softball assistant, and that is our Gopher Talk presented by Affinity Plus. So long.